Girl, stop apologizing.
Rachel Hollis has been on my nerves for years now. I've read tons of books by different self-help gurus in my life, and one of those gurus I gave a chance and my money to, unfortunately, was Rachel Hollis. I heard about her from so many people who said how funny and relatable Rachel was. I'm all about girl power and facial hygiene, so I gave her a try, and I went from open-minded curiosity to having a bad taste in my mouth pretty quick. There's lots to say about Rachel Hollis and why she sucks, honestly, but today I want to focus on the latest and possibly most blatant controversy she's been in, and it's all over this TikTok.
Okay, yesterday I was doing a live stream and I mentioned that there's a sweet woman who comes to my house twice a week and cleans. She's my house cleaner. She cleans the toilets. Someone commented and said, "You are privileged AF." And I was like, "You're right. I'm super freaking privileged, but also I worked my ass off to have the money to have someone come twice a week and clean my toilets." And I told her that, and then she said, "Well, you're unrelatable." What is it about me that made you think I want to be relatable? No, sis, literally everything I do in my life is to live a life that most people can't relate to. Most people won't work this hard. Most people won't get up at 4 a.m. Most people won't fail publicly again and again just to reach the top of the mountain. Literally, every woman I admire in history was unrelatable. If my life is relatable to most people, I'm doing it wrong.
Yikes. Okay, let's break this down line by line because there's so much to unpack.
Okay, yesterday I was doing a live stream and I mentioned that there's a sweet woman who comes to my house twice a week and cleans. She's my house cleaner. She cleans the toilets.
Why does she find it necessary to add that detail? She cleans my toilets. As if she needs to remind everyone that house cleaners clean toilets in addition to windows and kitchen counters. Like, what's the point of adding that? I don't get it. It's like, we get it that you're better than her in the way that you value success. So there's really no need to degrade her further. And she mentions it twice.
She cleans the toilets. I worked my ass off to have the money to have someone come twice a week and clean my toilets.
Okay, let's continue.
Someone commented and said, "You are privileged AF." And I was like, "You're right. I'm super freaking privileged."
I love her use of this hip language here, especially for what's coming next. And also, side note, her entire TikTok account is targeted at middle school and high school age girls.
Hey guys, Big Sister here, and I want to talk about breakouts. Been hanging out with a lot of you and getting questions about getting acne. And part of it is, dude, unfortunately, you are in middle school, you are in high school, your hormones are going crazy, which means you're gonna get it. So first thing to know, everyone gets pimples, everyone gets zits. It is what it is. I promise it gets better. Are you ready, middle school? Are you ready, high school? Because I came to play. That is the kind of confidence that you gotta walk in day one. What would you wear if you could wear anything on the first day of school? So comment below and let me know what it is. And then I feel like I'm gonna learn all about middle school and high school culture. And B, I just wanna envision the outfit that you're going for.
I just wanna envision the outfit that you're going for.
Huh? So like, what message is that supposed to be sending to these girls?
I worked my ass off to have the money to have someone come twice a week and clean my toilets.
I hope she didn't leave her ass in the toilet after she worked it off. Maybe that's why she's so angry. This cleaning woman probably wanted a raise after having to clean a literal ass out of the toilet. Girl, wash your face after you wash my ass out of the toilet.
And I told her that, and then she said, "Well, you're unrelatable." What is it about me that made you think I want to be relatable?
Oh, I don't know.
You guys, I do the same makeup every single day. That's because I've only perfected one way to do my makeup. Don't judge me.
Remember how gross we all were before this pandemic?
Her bio on TikTok is literally your big sister who just happens to be Rachel Hollis. It should say, if you don't have a private toilet servant, you're doing it wrong. All jokes aside, this is the biggest narcissistic mask slip I've probably ever seen. This is who Rachel probably has always been behind closed doors.
She just was really good at hiding it before. But something must have triggered her, and it could be related to her recent divorce or the fact that people are slowly starting to realize that she's a real person with cracks in her bubbly personality. I honestly predict her downfall will be pretty epic, and something dramatic and bigger than this scandal will happen before she's canceled officially.
No, sis. Literally everything I do in my life is to live a life that most people can't relate to.
I hate that.
Most people won't work this hard. Most people won't get up at 4 a.m.
All these self-help inspirational gurus are the same. If you want to be successful, wake up at 4 a.m. I used to wake up at midnight to be at work during my first job out of college. So in theory, I should be like a billionaire by now. But I actually made very little money and was miserable the whole time. And what time does Rachel think house cleaners wake up? I'm gonna make a separate video about hustle and success culture and what some of the big myths are. So if you have any, please leave it in the comments below.
Most people won't fail publicly again and again just to reach the top of the mountain. Literally, every woman I admire in history was unrelatable.
Oh God, okay, this part. So she mentions that most women she looks up to are unrelatable. All right, fine. But then in her caption, she lists specific women, which following her thought process means are on the same level as her. Since she's unrelatable and they're unrelatable, they're one and the same, right? So let's review the women she listed.
Harriet Tubman, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, Marie Curie, Oprah Winfrey, Amelia Earhart, Frida Kahlo, Malala Yousafzai, and finally.
This one is so weird. I admittedly had never heard of this person.
Empress Wu Zetian rose from royal concubine to become the only female ruler in China's 2,000 years of imperial history. Today, she is seen as ruthless, tyrannical, and willing to murder her own family to hold on to power.
Huh? Very interesting addition to this list. And one woman she left off the list was Rosa Parks, which is surprising because on her website, you can buy these shirts. I have a problem with merch like this because while the intentions might be good, she's profiting off a class of women who she obviously does not respect, if this TikTok is any evidence.
If my life is relatable to most people, I'm doing it wrong.
She recorded that last line like, damn, this will make an amazing quote to put on my new unrelatable boss babes line of planners. So I must include that Rachel apologized twice. Girl, stop apologizing. Both were not great. On April 4th, Hollis made her first apology, but it was an apology that basically said everyone had misinterpreted her and her team failed to do its job correctly.
So I couldn't find the original Instagram post anywhere, so I ripped it from Savvy Writes Books on YouTube. She's a great creator, talks about Rachel Hollis a lot. I definitely recommend you checking her out. This first apology is written, first of all, in the Notes app. So tacky, number one. So she says she will learn one day, but hasn't yet. And this is where it begins to kind of go downhill. She says, I'll learn that my intent and my impact can be wildly different things. I mean, I think that's obvious to everyone. You know, your intent is one thing, but it doesn't always mean that you're not hurting people when you say things just because your intent is good. She does say she apologizes, so that's good. And then we go down a dark rabbit hole of questions that are unrelated to the real problem at hand here. She says, was my post upsetting because I said I have someone who cleans my house twice a week? No, that's not why it's upsetting, and you know that. Everyone knows that. No one's accusing you of upsetting them because you have a house cleaner. And she goes on and says, I've talked a lot about this over the years. I have a nanny. I have someone who helps with cleaning. I have a team at work who helps to build this business. And I think it's crucial that I keep talking about it. I could very easily pretend that I don't have any assistance. Again, no one is saying that they're upset because you have a team. No one expects you to do everything by yourself. I think this is a projection of her own insecurity. And secondly, the fact that she is so openly willing to say that it would be better and easier for her, in essence, that she should pretend or could pretend she doesn't have anybody, is kind of revealing. She's even considered that she could pretend that she doesn't have any assistance. Why? Who's expecting this of you? She says, I'm sure it would make my brand more likable and certainly more relatable if I act like I achieve all these things through hard work
and organization. I guess, but, you know, it would be easier if everyone had $2 million, but that's just not the reality. This reminds me of the Hilaria Baldwin controversy. Like, yeah, it would be cool if you were Spanish, but you're not. Was my post upsetting because I mentioned some of my favorite women in history? No, that also was not the reason, and you know that as well. And then she goes on to say, this one is even harder for me because those women are the most badass I could think of. Someone on my team said, I think people believe you're comparing yourself to them. Yeah, because you were. There is no comparison. Okay, good. I'm glad we're acknowledging that. To believe that because I mentioned them, I am comparing myself to them is ludicrous. No, it's not. Okay, we're almost done. That was where things started, but because I still haven't learned, I didn't respond to these things on Friday when I heard that people were upset. I listened to my team instead of my gut. And I think her team was spot on when they said, you know, people think you're comparing yourself to these women. So maybe you should have listened to your team because they were right in that case.
And this isn't the first time she's blamed this elusive team for major mistakes.
So this was a post that Rachel made and it says, still, I rise. And this is a famous quote from Maya Angelou, who's a poet, obviously very famous person and woman of color. And Rachel did not credit Maya Angelou for this. There was this apology that was also just a deflection to blaming it on her team. It says, this morning I found out that my social team posted a graphic on my Instagram yesterday that said, still I rise. That is obviously an immortal line from a Maya Angelou poem, only no credit was given to her. So, okay, it seems like she's acknowledging the issue, however, that she, you know, is barely taking responsibility. She's saying, it's my fault for hiring these, like, completely idiotic people, and, you know, it's their fault, and I'm the boss, so I guess it's sort of my fault, but not really. If she didn't plagiarize a lot of other things, you might let this slide, but in a future video, like I said, we'll talk about her entire plagiarism history.
So after the first apology didn't get accepted, she deleted it and posted this one. Quote, I'm so deeply sorry for the things I said in my recent post and the hurt I have caused in the past few days. By talking about my own success, I diminished the struggles and hard work of many people who work tirelessly every day. No one's saying she shouldn't talk about her success, but you didn't have to put someone who is probably also a hard worker down in the process. And you shouldn't call your fans cis or compare yourself to women who actually made a difference to people of all levels of privilege. In future videos, we'll dive into Rachel's plagiarism controversy, MLM obsession, and the problem with these self-help gurus in general. Thanks for watching, please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.